Good morning, brothers and sisters. I hope everyone's having a great day. I'm very excited to bring this timely message the Lord has been speaking to my heart for a while now, and even more so in the last week. But before I get into all that, I want to humbly ask you guys if you could please either pause this video or after the video, please take 5 or 10 minutes to pray for a very, very dear friend of mine. She is my absolute best friend. I love her so much. I met her about 7 years ago, and since then we have just grown closer and closer in the Lord. We encourage each other. She has been a tremendous blessing in my life. She loves the Lord with all of her heart. She is very sick. She's been fighting sickness for about 2 weeks now, and about a week ago she was put in the hospital. And I have not heard anything since the day she let me know they were admitting her in the hospital. And I'm very worried about her, and it's very unlike her to not text me this long. So I'm very worried, and I just want to ask if you guys could just please pray for her like she was your own family member, because we're all brothers and sisters in Christ, and she's also waiting to hear the trumpet sound. She's waiting. She's ready for it. But this has come upon her, and she is in a very, very hard place right now fighting the sickness. So I pray that anybody who, feels led would pray for her, and please just try to pray for her like you would your own sister, because she is one of us, and I know God can move mountains, and He can help the doctors and help the nurses, and you know, just be there with her through this time, and pray for her family also. This is a very trying time for them as well. And pray for, she has a little boy that's 10 or 11. Please pray for him also. And I would very, very much appreciate that. Thank you so much in advance for anyone who does take the time to pray for her. I just love her so much. And I've just been praying for her for a week now. It's like 24/7. It's like all I can think of is I pray for her. So, anyways, thank you guys for whoever prays. Okay, first, before I get into this exciting thing that the Lord has been sharing with me, before I get into it, I want to give a disclaimer, sort of. And I've wrote down what I need to say because I'm still not great at YouTube, and I always try to do it, you know, without notes, and I always end up leaving out about 5 or 6 things. So I am still having to write everything down so that I'll remember when I do my videos. So please bear with me. Okay, first I want to stress that I absolutely believe the rapture is imminent and that nothing else has to happen for it to suddenly take place. Also, I don't know for sure that what I'm about to share is going to happen before the rapture. All I do know for sure, in absolute certainty, is that over the last year, and over the last few months especially, the Holy Spirit is and has been speaking to my heart about things that possibly may happen just prior to the rapture. And I have felt a strong urgency to share this quickly. I had already prepared my notes last night and was going to make the video, but decided to wait till this morning because it had gotten too late. But now I'm glad I did, because before bed, I was laying down, getting ready to sleep, and was finishing a video that I had started watching by Steve Mack 88. The video was called Feast of Trumpets 2021 Rapture Dreams / Jesus is Coming Very Soon. And he just uploaded this last night, if you want to go to his YouTube and watch. I had closed my eyes while listening, and around the 12-minute, 31-second mark, the lady in the video starts to talk about the 10 virgins. And all of a sudden, she ends up saying, "When we all know 100% that the rapture is imminent, as if something happens that we will all know the rapture is 100% at the door, there will not be enough time to get ready." When she finished saying this, My eyes shot wide open, and heat literally went from the top of my head to the soles of my feet. Because just a few hours earlier, I had just wrote basically the same thing when preparing for my video. Then she goes into some dreams that she's had in the past of being in a wedding. And in those dreams, she was not prepared or not having enough time to get prepared. And also not having her dress on. And what was incredible about that is I had just uploaded a dream I had a few weeks ago where I was getting married in the dream, and it was like I was in a dressing room, and I also did not have my dress on. And either my dress was not the right color, or I did not have one. And then, in the dream, I had washed my hair. Because I did not have time to keep focusing on my dress. And when I took the towel off my head and looked in the mirror, I had different color stripes in my hair, like I was tainted, and someone had sprayed different color stripes in my hair. And in the dream, I knew I did not have time to fix it either, because the wedding was about to start. And that's the only dream I've ever had about getting married, which was just this summer. But the lady in the video said she's had many dreams like this. So in her dreams, she said there will be a final call where it will not be a guess any longer, and that this final call that happens, we will all know beyond a shadow of a doubt that the rapture is about to happen any minute. So after hearing her say this, I knew why I had put off making my video till morning, and I knew instantly that this was a confirmation from the Holy Spirit of what He has been showing me. And He basically used the same language with her as He did with me. So, after saying all that, this was what I wrote last night. So this was not even written. Any of this was not even written after I heard that video. Okay, so I'm going to go into what the Lord has been showing me. The Lord has been speaking to my heart majorly about Damascus in the last few days. I saw the news story about Israel striking some places in and around the Damascus area when suddenly a light bulb went off in my spirit. I heard the statement or question come up in my spirit, will Damascus be destroyed just prior to the rapture? And then I said, what would be the significance of Damascus being destroyed just prior to the rapture? And then the Holy Spirit reminded me that Damascus was where Saul became Paul, and where Paul was commissioned to be the apostle of the Gentiles. Paul, who once was persecuting Christians, converted to Christianity on the road to Damascus. So then the Holy Spirit had me look a little deeper into the significance of Damascus, and found that Damascus is a symbol of transformation, where Paul was blinded by a light, which was Jesus, from heaven. On a side note, while looking this up, I found out that supposedly a tiny shrine in Damascus holds a casket that supposedly contains the head of John the Baptist. And John the Baptist was the one preaching, "Repent, for the kingdom of God is at hand." Is this true? I don't know, but I find it very interesting. Damascus was one of the first regions to receive Christianity during the ministry of Peter. Damascus also still contains a sizable portion of Christians, with some churches all over the city. This is also where Paul had to flee from persecution, which could be a foreshadow of what's coming to those in the world and believers who are left behind after the rapture happens. Paul is the one that traveled widely throughout Eastern Europe, the Eastern Roman Empire, spreading the good news that Jesus would return from heaven soon and usher in the kingdom of God. It also says, which most of us already know, that Paul could be viewed as the founder of Christianity. And Paul was from the area of Damascus, which was in Syria. You can see that where he mentions that in Galatians. In sharing just some of the things I found, and this is just a short list of the significance of Damascus being destroyed just before the rapture, if you are able to watch my other video called "Is the Midnight Cry About to Go Out?", I go over how the Holy Spirit has been opening my eyes to a possible major event that will happen just prior to the actual rapture. Because in the 10 virgin parable, there is a midnight cry that goes out, and there seems to be something so big that all the virgins, foolish and the wise, wake up, and they all seem to know the bridegroom is at the door. And the wise go out to meet the bridegroom, and the foolish run to the wise for oil. But by the time the midnight cry goes out, it's already too late for the foolish virgins. So what major event could happen that all the virgins seem to instantly know the hour has come and Jesus is at the door? Well, it could actually be the sudden destruction of Damascus, because most all Christians know this must happen in the last days. Lukewarm or not, most Christians know this prophecy. The ones with oil and the ones without oil. If they woke up one morning to see Damascus completely destroyed, they would all know the trumpet is about to sound. But why could Damascus be that event that could be the midnight cry that goes out just before the bridegroom comes and takes the wise and the door is shut to the foolish? Because it would signify the end of the church age, the end of grace, and the end of the Gentile age. If this could happen, or if this is the event, then we would absolutely know the rapture is at the door. And we still would not know the day or hour, because it could be a day later, or a week later, or even 2 weeks or a month later that the rapture happens. So that's pretty much what the Lord was drawing my attention to, that if we woke up tomorrow morning and Damascus is completely and utterly destroyed, foolish and the wise Christians would wake up. And it's at that moment, if that happens, if an event happens just prior to the rapture, and if it is Damascus, I can see why Damascus could be that call that goes out, the midnight hour call that goes out. And the wise go out to meet the bridegroom, and the foolish run to the wise because they have no oil. But they all know the midnight call has gone out. And Damascus was where, you know, Christianity started. It was a big Christian place. It still has a lot of Christians there. It was where Paul met Jesus on the road to Damascus with a transformation. He saw a light from heaven. When we are raptured, we're going to see a light from heaven. You know, we're going to be blinded by that light, because we're not going to be able to see in the natural anymore. We're going to be seeing in heaven. It could just be a very big sign that, you know, the end of the Gentile age is over. We have come to the end of the Gentiles being grafted in, and the branches that weren't ready are going to be cut off. The ones who weren't producing fruit are not going to be able to enter in, because the door is going to be shut. So there could be a major reason why Damascus could be the sign just prior to the rapture. It would signify many things. It would also signify, just like Paul had to flee from persecution, it would also be a sign to the ones that are going to be left behind, the ones who were lukewarm, the ones who were not right with God, that they are going into great persecution. Because we know the tribulation saints, they can still make it to heaven, but they're going to be martyred for their faith. They don't have to be martyred now. These events have not happened now, if there's an event that will happen just prior to the rapture. And like I said at the beginning, the rapture is at the door. It could happen before I even finish this video. But the Holy Spirit has been giving me so many confirmations, that's what blows my mind. These are, you know, just like me listening to that video last night. I don't know that lady, but But it's as if the Holy Spirit was telling her the same exact thing he was telling me. If there's an event or something that happens that we know beyond a shadow of a doubt that the rapture is absolutely imminent, if that happens, there will be no time to get ready. So if somebody is even listening to this and you're waiting on things to get worse, or you're waiting on some big event to happen, or you're waiting for New York City to be nuked, or something major, Damascus even being destroyed, if you're waiting for a big event, you don't have time to wait. What if there is a midnight call that physically goes out in the earth that wakes up all the foolish and all the wise? If there is, then by the time that event happens, it's already too late. Of course, whoever's listening to this could die tomorrow and may not even see this. So we all need to be ready to meet the Lord. But there is a remnant that's going in the rapture. Not all Christians are going. Those who have one foot in the world and one foot with God are not going. They are double-minded, lukewarm people. They try to serve two masters. They serve the God of this world, and they serve Jesus. And one always overrides the other. And when you've got a foot in the world and a foot with God, the Holy Spirit's going to back off. And he's going to allow the God of this world to take over. So you're going to be feeding your flesh a lot more than you're going to be feeding your spirit. I am telling you, the rapture is at the door. There is no time left. There is no time left to get ready. There's just none. Today, do whatever you've got to do to seek his face. Get oil in your lamp. My goodness, get in your word. Get in the Bible, absorb it. Start walking it out. Produce fruit so that you're not cut down. Any tree that does not bear good fruit will be cut down. Bear fruit. Walk out your front door every day, bearing fruit with the joy of the Lord. Be a blessing to others. Don't go out judging other people all the time. Half of them are going to hell anyways. What little bit of mercy they can get on this earth, they need to see it in us. We are the witness. God's not going to hold them responsible. If we're the ones not exempting his character, he's going to hold us responsible. We are supposed to be the ones producing fruit. The ones who don't know God like we do, the ones that we know are not seeking God and do not have the knowledge and the wisdom that we have in God, he's not going to hold them responsible. He's going to hold you responsible for not being the person we're supposed to be called to be, which is by the power of the Holy Spirit, of course, because it's not easy. But just getting back to what I was sharing, could it be that Damascus is literally about to be destroyed? Could it be that in the middle of the day, because it's nighttime over there now, it could be in the middle of the day here in America, and we hear the news reports that Damascus has been utterly destroyed? If that happens, then we would all know the rapture is at the door. Does that mean it happens an hour later? Does it happen 24 hours later? Does it happen a week later? I don't know, but what I do know, if I go forward in my mind and picture that and pretend like that's already happened, you know, like hindsight's 20/20, when you look back on something, I know tomorrow if that happened, all of us would know the rapture is imminent. The rapture's at the door. But the worst part is that it's already going to be too late for the foolish virgins. And deep down, they will know it's too late. The time to seek God is now. Do away with all of your idols. Don't make God have to leave you behind, and then you decide that you're going to forsake television, that you're going to forsake being hooked on TV shows, that you're going to forsake this world. You can be refined and made a bride without spot or blemish now. You can do this and allow the Holy Spirit to do this in you before you miss the rapture. That's our blessed hope. But if you've not been totally refined in his fire, gold tried in the fire, by the time that trumpet sounds, if you've still got one foot in the world and one foot with God, you're not going. Period. There is too much in the Word of God that points us to that. Throughout the whole Bible, God doesn't address the wicked. He addresses the ones that call themselves believers to repent. The seven churches are not to sinners. The seven churches are to people who claim to be believers. But one group has compromised in every area, and the other group is asking from the Lord gold tried in the fire. So I pray that this reaches somebody, and you know, this is just exciting times. It's like a double-edged sword. It's exciting times, and it's very dreadful times, because we all have loved ones that we know are going to be left behind. We know they're not going unless God supernaturally does something pretty quick, and He can. There is nothing too hard for our God. But I just wanted to put this out there about Damascus. And of course, there's other big events that could happen too. But it looks like it could be Damascus, because Damascus represents the start of Christianity. The rapture represents a place of transition, which we are going to be translated to heaven. We're going to be transformed. It would signify the end of the church age, the end of the Gentiles. It would just, in the natural, it would signify, okay, God is now done with the Gentiles. He is taking His focus back to His people, back to the Jews, and the end of grace is over. So it would be a major sign if it was Damascus destroyed, if that's the midnight hour call. So please, please share comments if you know, if the Lord's been speaking to you, anything along these, even if it's just an event that might happen, or, again, I will say nothing has to happen for the rapture, but what if it does? Because the Holy Spirit has definitely been waking me up to the parable of the 10 virgins in the last year. That much I do know, without a doubt. And He continues to do it, that there could be an event that happens just moments before the rapture. So I pray you guys have a great day, a great weekend. If I have anything else, or if I get any more confirmations, which I believe I will, even if it's a short video, I'll upload it. And sorry this was so long, but it was worth it. Be excited in the Lord. Have the joy of the Lord, because the joy of the Lord is our strength. Our King is coming, and the trumpet is absolutely about to sound. God bless you guys. Have a great day.